Hoi An, a city in Vietnam's central coast known for its well-preserved ancient town cut through with canals. This city is well known for its architecture, which consists of wooden shophouses, temples, beautiful lanterns along its street and riverboats.
There are many exciting places to visit from Hoi An. In this video, we are going to show you what to do when you are in Hoi An. If you are new to our channel, be sure and subscribe because we are going to take you all over Vietnam starting from south to north in budget. Welcome to Vietnam.
Hi guys, good morning. So we are in Hoi An and we are staying at the Sun Homestay. We'll link it in the description box. You can check the place. We are here for 2 nights. And let us show you the places you can visit in Hoi An. So we rented a motorbike and the price is 100,000 dong for 1 day.
After Nha Trang, we took an overnight bus to Hoi An. It was 508 kilometers, that is approx 11 hours journey. And we reached Hoi An at 6 a.m. To know more on our bus journey and what we did in Nha Trang, do check our previous vlog. The link is provided in the description box. We checked into our hotel, freshed up and rested for a while. Today our plan was to visit Marble Mountain and explore the ancient town in Hoi An. Distance from Hoi An to Marble Mountain is 8 kilometers.
So we've reached the Marble Mountains and the entrance for Marble Mountain is 40,000 dong per person. And we've got the tickets, so let's explore.
Marble Mountains. These are the cluster of 5 hills made from limestone and marble in Da Nang. It is well known for its pilgrim site, cave, peak, tunnels, and temples named after the elements metal, wood, water, fire, and earth. At least 3 to 4 hours to explore these marble mountains, and we recommend comfortable shoes while attempting this hike. And it is good to start early in the morning to avoid huge crowd and sun. All temples and caves in these areas are awesome, out of which their lantern cave is worth watching. It is small but deep and filled with lava along. Most popular highlights is climbing up the Marble Mountains and enjoying spectacular view across Non Nhoc, also known as Mai Khe Beach. Out of all these hills, our personal favorite was the highest peak, Mount Thui. This is accessible to tourists and provides a panoramic view of coast, Da Nang and other Marble Mountains.
So after the Marble Mountains, we are here at the ancient town of Hoi An.
This city is full of lanterns on street, river boats, and most of the shops here are made of wood. Another must-see in Hoi An is the Japanese covered bridge, which dates back to the 18th century, and tickets to this is 18,000 dong. Sometimes the entrance is free. This is a wooden bridge created by Japanese then living in Hoi An as a way to reach Chinese quarters across the water. After this comes the best part for which we decided to stay in Hoi An. This is the famous banh mi.
So we are here to have banh mi. This is some famous shop where banh mi is really famous, and we're gonna try that. guys, if you are in Hoi An, you must definitely come to this place and try banh mi. They have a lot of options in banh mi. They have vegetarian options as well. And apart from banh mi, they also have some very good stuff. We also had some spring rolls that is wrapped in rice paper. So just check out this place and keep it in your list to visit this place.
Next day, our plan was to visit Bana Hills. Bana Hills is roughly 45 kilometers away from Hoi An, so we recommend to start early morning.
Hi guys, good morning. This is day 2 in Hoi An, and we are here in the Bana Hills. This was approx 44 kilometers away from our hotel. We chose to ride instead of taking a private tour. But if in case you don't want to ride, you can always take a private tour. They will charge you approx 1 million dong. That will include the ticket, that is 700,000, and the transportation and the food cost. So let's explore the Bana Hills. Come follow.
To get into the park, you will have to take a cable car. The Bana Hills cable car is the highest and longest cable car system in the world, stretching 5,800 meters long and peaks at 1,368 meters high, and offers a spectacular view of Da Nang and surrounding forests, mountains, beautiful waterfalls along its way. Climate on top was simply awesome. Bana Hills, situated at 35 kilometers from Da Nang city and 44 kilometers from ancient city of Hoi An in Vietnam. Bana Hills is famous for its French village, which buildings look like castles, a majestic golden bridge, some beautiful gardens, temples, and amusement park in it.
This place is really awesome and freezing.
First thing, we went to explore Golden Bridge.
Okay, so now we will be visiting the Golden Bridge, and we are alone in the cable car. Oh my god, we cannot see anything.
Golden Bridge, 150 meters long pedestrian bridge. It is designed to connect the cable car station with the gardens so that it can avoid a steep incline and also provide a scenic overlook. Golden Bridge is quite popular among tourists, and it has two giant stone hands which are designed to support the structure. After exploring this bridge, we visited Lin Yung Pagoda. This is 1,500 meters above sea level. This pagoda is one of the three pagodas named Lin Yung in Da Nang. The main attraction of pagoda is beautiful white 27 meters tall Buddha statue. Then we visited this beautiful decorated garden where you can take some pictures. DB Wine Cellar. This wine cellar was constructed by the French in 1923 with an aim of preserving different types of wine. If you are a wine lover, you must visit this place. Banna Hills also consists of Fantasy Park, which offers fun rides and games for both children and adults. Here we also tried another alpine roller coaster, same like we did in Dalat. If you haven't seen our Dalat video, do watch. Link is given in the description box. After all this, we spend our time in French Village. It is described as a miniature Europe in the heart of Da Nang. You will experience the beautiful architecture of Renaissance Europe right in Vietnam, with replicas of church, shops and hotels. After this, we went back by cable car, followed by a motorbike ride to our hotel in Hoi An. Next day, we had our flight to Hanoi from Da Nang. That was our fourth of several Vietnam vlogs to come. Stay tuned because next we will be taking you to Hanoi and Ha Long Bay. If you enjoyed this video, do hit the like button. And if you want to continue watching our Vietnam journey, be sure and subscribe. Also hit that bell icon so that you are notified when the next video is posted. If you are watching this video on Facebook, do like our Facebook page. Also follow us on Instagram for more updates. That ends our Hoi An vlog. We'll see you in Hanoi.